Swinging 60s, Harry B. He's still on. Oh yeah, he's playing the slow ballads from the 57. Oh my. Let's ring up this. Ring up, Harry. Where are you, Harry? Before. There's Harry. Yay! Hello, Harry. We're back. Oh. Four songs left? Okay. Let's talk a little bit and then play the rest.
Hold on. I'm turning this off.
Harry's back.
I thought you'd gone. I thought we'd lost the connection.
No, I kept having to go back to the hilltop. All these people buying me birthday beers.
I've got four songs left.
Oh, gosh.
Four songs left? Okay.
Can't wait.
A little bit and then play the rest.
Okay. Hold on. I'm turning this off. We've got the old loop thing.
We're back to the old loop.
Again. That's annoying, isn't it?
Why don't you play another
connection?
No, I kept having to go back to
play another song and I'll call you back. See you later, Harry.
I've got four songs left.
Oh, gosh.
Can you hear me back?
Okay, I'll call you back. See you in a bit, Harry.
We've got the old loop thing.
We're back to the old loop.
That's annoying, isn't it?
Why don't you play
the connection?
No, I kept having to go back to
play another song and I'll call you back. See you later, Harry.
I've got four songs left.
Oh, gosh.
I'll tell you what, I'll ring you back, okay? This
is no good. Okay, I'll call you back. Ever in my heart.
The Swinging 60s. True devotion. Your first love.
Young love, our love we share with deep emotion.
from your sweet lips will tell me that your love is real, and I can feel that it's true. We will vow to one another there will never be another love for you or for me. Young love, first love, filled with true devotion.
There you are. Hi, Harry. We got it with no loop. Yay. Talk to me. Talk to me, Harry.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you just great.
That's good. We're having this loop thing, and I don't know what that is.
It went away.
You know, on the old Skype, I have my contacts, and all my contacts are lit up green as if to say they're available. But when it comes to John B., it's blanked out and puffs. That's the reason why we're having this loop thing. Not
okay. Too sure. Well, it seems like the loop is gone now.
Okay.
What would you like what would you like to talk about?
Why you got this short shave tonight?
I got in a fight with the lawnmower and lost.
How's the hair?
Feels good. Nice and cold. John just turned the swamp cooler on, so it's nice and breezy. It's about 96 degrees outside, so this is a great relief.
That's too hot for me.
Yeah.
We don't get 96.
Not
the warmest we ever got, I think, was about 78, 79. And we thought that was hot.
Yeah.
But, no. This is a good thing about the four seasons, the old spring, summer, autumn, winter. People complain, but it's nature's way of evening things out.
That's right.
So,
I was just
when
thinking,
you say 90 degrees, how long will you have that for?
Another week.
And that will be a total of how many weeks?
Well, it'll just be in the 90s for the next 7 days. That's according to the weather forecast.
So where will it go from then?
Might go down to the 80s or 70s. Occasionally it gets in. Occasionally it gets into the hundreds. In Colorado, the weather changes a lot. So we can have sometimes 70 degrees one day and 15, like freezing, the next day.
So how many seasons do you have?
We have four seasons here.
Ah, are they equally divided?
Yes, they are definitely divided. And John, who has lived here longer than me, can tell you for sure there's some bitterly cold winters, but not quite as cold as it gets in the Midwest and the northern, as they say, the northern tier states like Minnesota and Wisconsin. But
you'd rather have that. You wouldn't have a great desire to go back to Seattle, no?
I like Seattle. It's a very mild and temperate climate, but it just rains a lot and there's not as much sunshine. Here we have sunshine practically every day.
Yeah, but when you get sunshine, you lose the hair and you grow a beard. Where in Seattle, it wouldn't be the other way around.
Yeah. Yeah. In Seattle, you wear woolen clothes year-round and have a beard that goes, you know, you look like a Sikh. You have a huge beard. That's how you get by in the Northwest, because you're always wet.
Tell me, Dale, because I've noticed this over time. Well, not so much John B., because he obviously shaves a lot. But people in Denver and Colorado seem to grow enormous beards. Is it the sun? Is it the whole way of life?
Could be the way of life because the mountains are here. The mountain men, you know, their guys are skiing, and in the old days they were trappers and things like that, and miners. They didn't have access to any shaving equipment, so a lot of the old cores, beards, ads, you'll see lots of guys with beards.
So if a guy you met in a pub tonight was, say, 40 years of age, and he had a shiny chin, would you assume perhaps he might be a little bit gayish in manner?
I would just assume that he works downtown at a regular job and has to be, you know, report to somebody who's monitoring him for at least 40 hours a week. So yeah, there's a lot of guys that look real trim and real sharp around here, and then there's the rest that have all kinds of hair. You know, reggae and Rasta is very popular here, and people pretty much dress and groom themselves the way they want. There's a wide variety of acceptance in the state of Colorado, which is not like that in a lot of other states in America.
So could you see yourself in the future leaving Denver?
No, I think I'm going to remain based in Denver forever just because I love the sunshine and I like the people here. I am attracted to California and obviously still attracted to Seattle. I like Vancouver, BC, you know, British Columbia, Canada, Vancouver Island. So Pacific Northwest is really my home, but I've found that being based out here in Denver is a lot better for me right now.
That's good.
Not that I'm doing anything in particular, Harry.
Are you happy with your little lot, as they say?
Yeah, life never turns out like you plan, but I found a great amount of happiness in my life, and I think there's going to be some surprising things happening in the next 3 years. Stay tuned, Harry. We promise to be entertaining.
So, 57 is not the man's menopause, then. It's a kind of a onward and upward figure.
Yeah, you better have your stuff together by the time you're 57. Like, John, I think he's well into his 60s, and looks like he's had it together for the last 10 or 20 years. So, at some point, you need to make peace with yourself and the people around you, and hopefully I'm doing that.
Are you telling me John B. is over the age of 60?
Yes.
What would he admit to? What age would he admit to?
I've never seen his driver's license, so he's sitting on the couch right now watching the soccer game, Netherlands and Costa Rica, I think, is still 0-0.
Has he got a milk bottle with a dummy teat in the end of it?
I don't know what you're talking about, Harry. Anyway, John John is a very careful drinker because of a diabetes situation, so...
Yeah.
He's, in terms of his age, I think he's ageless, timeless, and... I don't pin him down on anything because I would say John's doing better than ever. He's happy, he's traveling, he's playing a lot of music, but I'm not sure if he'll tell me how old he is. He's scratching his chin. He's remaining not going to say. You could probably look at his face.
I haven't mentioned this before.
Just Google him, I'm sure there's...
good friend.
Yeah.
He lives in Queensland and Australia.
Yeah.
I've grown with him, and he's called Ellis Blackburn. He's been there for 20 years, but when I see John B., there's a remarkable resemblance with my good friend in Australia.
They call that doppelganger.
Is that what it is?
Mm-hmm. Someone who's very similar to you. Doppelganger. Yeah, I think it's a German word, and it means someone who's very similar to you. And I get that a lot. Whether I have a beard or a clean shaven or however I change myself, I always look like... You know, somebody thinks I look like a doppelganger of their friend, and I constantly have people coming up to me and say, "Hey, Fred, how you doing?" "No, my name's Dale. Fred, I'm Fred's evil twin," or whatever. You know, joke around
so
about it.
Who do you think you are?
I have no idea, Harry. We're figuring that out as we go. Maybe after my vacation in Moab, I'll write you a document describing who I am. Maybe by then I'll figure it out.
Okay.
No, just thinking back on all the 1950s.
52 songs, okay?
No, no, no. I'm enjoying talking to you. No more
hopefully
music. You have
hopefully
two songs left?
The rest of the day.
Wait, we're talking at the same time. This is fun. This is like Monty Python. No, I wanted to tell you something about 1957. My brother Mark, I have three older brothers, and my oldest brother Mark reminded me that we actually had a 1957 Ford station wagon, and I was not able to pronounce that. So I would say 50 Deva 7 Ford. So we call it the 50 Deva 7 Ford. So our family would get a new car every 7 years. So we had one in 57 and one in, actually we had just 5 years. I think we got a 62 Oldsmobile, and we tend to get a car every 5 years. I got to dig up some photos of that because, you know, that was, you know, they got the car the same year I was born. And it was me and my three older brothers all in the station wagon. And then we do have one photo in the Oldsmobile Super 88, which is really a muscle car. And there's a photo of us as kids in that car, which we redid that photo in the 70s, and we need to find an Oldsmobile. So we're all still alive, so it'll be fun to redo that picture again in the next few years.
Did you find yourself when you get to a certain age, did you look back more than you did before?
Probably. I try to limit that. Occasionally I can find myself in an emotional state thinking about the way things were, both the good and the bad, you know. So I try to live in the moment. You know, there's a lot of philosophers that say it's very important to live in the moment. So I've been concentrating on that. But, you know, the reality is you plan for the future and you think about the past all along. And so you need to have a balance of those things. But my little growth action in the last 10 years, I think, has been to live in the moment more. And I think better things grow out of that when you can live in the moment. And, you know, that's the nice thing about podcasting. That really puts you right here, right on the dot. You have to be on top of things, you know. I couldn't do what you do, Harry. It's a lot of buttons and knobs to take. I love doing my videos and my uploading and YouTube things and corresponding with people on social media. But I found it really taxing and difficult to do podcasting and playing music like that. Although I would love to do an occasional program with you.
Yeah, no problem.
If we get better,
we'll do it soon. Sooner than later.
Yeah. What would the program be about?
Before you get to 60.
Yeah, let's do a few before I get to 60. We have no idea what's happening, but this is actually for the Blindheim family. This is the birthday month. My father and two brothers were all born on June 27th, so that would be half the family. So they had a big party for my father, who's just turned 90 last week, and that was very sweet. They had a cake with all of the brothers' names on it, and the grandchildren, and the great-grandchildren, and the for my father, two more great-great-grandchildren on the way. They wrote plus two at the bottom of the cake, because I think there's two more kids on the way in the Blindheim family.
That's good. Do you kind of get the feeling, because your dad is 90, you're only a spring chicken, and there's lots of years to go?
You can think that, but there's been 33 years between my grandfather Ole and my father Alvin, and there's 33 years between Alvin and me. So it really, also my father is in assisted living now, so it lets me know I have about 33 more years to make a good
that's
life.
That's great, isn't it?
I hope so. I hope, yeah. So that's kind of a motivator too. I bet it could cause you to maybe give up, because who knows, Harry? We'll talk about this philosophy as we go along, but you caught me on a really good day. It's my birthday, and I'm happy, and I have friends like you and John B. and everybody that wants me to buy everybody that wants to buy a beer for me over at the Hilltop.
That's
so
good.
Life is good.
Hey,
then I go to the coffee shop this evening. What?
Finally, I want to say thank you to John B. because he's kind of accommodated you. He hasn't shown himself.
That's what
he's
I say. I always tell everybody
that.
Okay. Yeah, Harry, I happen to be on assisted living already, because I couldn't live without my friends and all the assistance that they give me. That's for sure. Is Samo still out there?
Yeah.
Yo, Harry, what?
Yeah, it's a pleasure knowing you, and happy birthday. I'm glad I put a few tunes together. Halfway through, I kind of thought to myself, Dale's not going to turn up, but I'm glad you did, okay? So, I'm going to leave you. I've got four tunes on my playlist. Dark Moon by Gail Starr.
Okay.
Ross Hamilton, Rainbow, Perry Como, Round and Round, and Bobby Helms, My Special Angel. What's your last tune?
My Special Angel.
You sure?
Yeah, that would be a good one to end it with. But you know, Harry, you know how much I love Irish traditional music and all the traditional music from the Celtic lands? While those four songs are playing, you can find some traditional music that was released in 1957, and you can keep your I'm always encouraging you to keep your program going for 3 hours.
Hey, it's a long time. 3 hours is a long time. You admit it.
I do admit it.
So much you wouldn't want to do for 2 hours.
That's something
do it for 3 hours.
You're so good at it. Have you got wine left?
Just a little bit.
Okay.
So I'll raise you to it, okay?
All right.
Neil, happy
yes.
birthday, okay?
Okay. Here's my coffee. And cheers to you. You're my special angel, Harry. Well,
all
what?
The best, Dale.
Oh, thank you so much. Let's do it again soon.
Have a good night.
All right. Thank you, Bill Gates, for the Skype. Actually worked.
Bobby Helms, my special angel, Dale here. See ya.
Take care.
God bless you.
God bless you right back, Harry. Waving. Thumbs up. Oh, and namaste. See if you recognize it. See my namaste? Thumbs up. Namaste. Rock on. Throw on the horns. Oh, we did namaste. All right. Perfect way. Perfect way to end.
Bye.